the only possible role Uganda played was one of example, because we had also our own problems here. We managed to fight the dictatorship and overthrow it. And those young people were living here. So they saw what we were doing. And as people with problems, they said, okay, maybe we can also do the same in our own country. You know, the infectiousness of the contagion of ideas, how ideas spread.
Yesterday, a senior Rwandan government official accused you of supplying arms to the RPF. Are you?
We are not helping the RPF. That used to be the old accusation. We invited the United Nations troops to come and station themselves at the border. Right now they are there. So this is all rubbish.
What has been your advice to the RPF? Do you think this war is winnable?
It's possible. I think they can take power. It's possible, but they will have to do it slowly because they don't have the equipment. This is also another contradiction because if we were backing them, as some people say, they would be having very good equipment, more modern, able to fight a fast war. But the equipment they have is, from my intelligence, is that it is a type which cannot fight a quick war. They may be good fighters, they may win in the end, but it will have to be slow. And the slower it is, the bigger the humanitarian problems will become. Displacement and so on and so forth. And since the Arusha agreement provided for power sharing, and since the recent resolution in Geneva about the genocide provides for an international commission of inquiry and also for an international tribunal to try the criminals, I think this would be a good moment to accept a ceasefire and then utilize those two documents.
Do you think the United Nations has been slow to react to the war in Rwanda?
Yes, my answer is yes, it has been too slow. That's A. But B, I don't know whether it could react faster. I'm not very sure that it could.
What do you see as the solution? How will the war be resolved?
Collective efforts by all of us to keep on advising, talking, you see.
And do you think it's possible in Rwanda?
I think so, because they have got two alternatives, either to continue fighting or to have peace. What other alternatives do they have?